Well, today I'm going to show you, a lot of you guys buy a second-hand amplifier or receiver, and today I'm going to show you how to test your amplifier or receiver before connecting your speakers. Because if you have old, very cheap speakers, you can use those speakers, you know, but if you don't have those cheap old speakers, you know, you don't have to take a risk with your expensive speakers, you know, because a bad amplifier or receiver will blow up your speakers. I already blew up my Magnat 05 in the past, and recently I blew up both tweeters in my Canton Ergo RCLs, yeah. And lucky for me, I bought secondhand two pairs of reserve tweeters. One pair I will change in my Cantons, and the other one stay in my house as reserve. And to do that, you see here 2 meters. This one is from Simon. What is the value of this meter?
It's new in the shop, around 500 euro.
500 euro, okay. This is a 500 euro meter. Yeah, I'm gonna show you. Thing is heavy, my friends. And it's completely automatic. And he will show you how this thing works. And here we have my cheap meter from 10 euro. This is the price you pay. Sometimes you can even find it for 8 or 9 euro, you know. This is the price I paid for this cheap meter, but this cheap meter will do. And he's going to show you how to first to test it with this cheap meter and then with this more expensive meter. And I advise everybody to, if you don't have a meter in your house and you like stereo equipment and you're changing all the time amplifier or receivers, and it is your hobby like it is my hobby, to buy something like this. This is 10 euro, my friends. You will not feel 10 euro in your pocket, you know. And I'm going to show you how this meter can save your speakers, you know, because I was lucky to score new tweeters for my Cantons, you know, but sometimes it also blew up a woofer, and then you have a bigger problem. Tweeters is easy to find secondhand. And what you're gonna do is, you place on this thing, have this amplifier have speaker A, B, and C connection, and then place it on speaker A connection.
Yeah, to C. No speakers connected to C.
C?
Yeah. Okay. I have no speakers connected to C, so it's easier.
Okay, there are no speakers connected on C, you know, because on A and B there are speakers connected. And you can place the volume just on zero. That doesn't matter. Yeah. Okay. Before you're gonna test, he's gonna explain you. Simon is going to explain you how to use this meter on to test your speakers.
So you turn on the meter and you put it to DC millivolts. Yes. And DC, you recognize of this symbol.
Yeah, the V with the...
Yeah, that down below, that little stripe.
And what is the other one?
That's AC, that's alternate current.
AC, so yes. We need DC volt, you see?
Yeah.
And you put it on 200 millivolt.
Yes, you want them on millivolts.
Okay. That's how you have to use this meter to test your speakers. Okay, next thing, we left the C... Speaker C connection without speakers, okay, going to test.
Now, normally, if you have an amplifier with a relay and the relay kicks in, it's probably good, but you can measure it to just be sure. Now, you take the black one and put it on the minus of the speaker connections, and you take the red one and you put it on the plus side of the speaker connections, and it reads now about zero. There's basically nothing. Now, if this first cipher we be around 4, so it will be 40 millivolts, you might want to put it a bit down. So you have to download the schematic and you can adjust the millivolts on the outputs. If it is around 80 on it, don't connect speakers because they will blow up your tweeters. And you do the same thing for the other side. That one reads around 1.8.
So there is a difference.
Yes.
Is that...
No, this will not hurt your speakers. It will
but
not...
But why is there a difference?
The power amplifiers have to be adjusted. Just so, a small bit, but this will not hurt.
There's nothing to do with this level,
no.
Sir? No, nothing
this
to do.
It's actually inside the amplifier. So you have to screw it open.
Okay, so it doesn't matter if the one reads 0 and or the other one reads 18.
No.
The fact is that when it is 40, you have to...
You can dial it down.
You will not take a risk with your expensive speakers.
I just wouldn't.
Okay, and it is 80, it is 100% sure your speakers will blow up.
Yes.
80 or above.
But normally the relay won't kick in. But there are amplifiers without relays, so just to be sure, check it.
Yeah. But I discovered. And also, this is of course, my friends, not a 100% proof that you are certainty that you will not blow up your computer or your speakers, because suppose that thing is okay. Yeah. You can also have a very dirty switch, but do plop.
Yes.
And even if this test is okay, yeah, you will still blow up your tweeter, your woofer, if one of those switches are dirty. So I always recommend it, even if you...
No, the second test, you just use the headphones. Put in your headphones and
yes.
Just turn every knob. If you hear loud scratches and loud noise, just clean the knobs first. If you don't hear anything or just small scratches, it won't hurt.
So that's the second test, my friends.
Yes. And
the
then you know test. For sure, then you know for sure that your amplifier is okay, you can connect your expensive speakers. There is then no need to put on small, cheap speakers.
So, two steps. First,
yes.
The meter test.
Yes.
Second test, the headphone test. And you try out all the knobs, you know, if there's not one, for example, even here there can be a dirty switch that you can plop and you know you will blow up one of your drivers in your speakers. And if you have expensive speakers, my friend, that's not what you want. That's why you have to use first the headphones. And okay, now he will use the same test, but he will use that expensive 500 euro. Costing meter, because this guy is a pro and he don't use 10. This is how it is looking.
You put it on exactly the same millivolts, but yeah. Mine measures automatically, so don't have a range.
Yes.
As you can see here, you have a range from different sizes.
Yes.
And mine does it automatically. And I don't have to do anything. And you do the same procedure. Red on the plus and minus on the min, or the black on the min. And the diode is basically nothing.
It's all about the same as the cheap meter, right?
Yes. And the other one.
Yeah, it's about the same. So yes. my cheap meter measures very good.
Yes, it does.
What's the difference between this voltage, this V and this V?
This is normal volts, or normal DC volts. So those millivolts are a tenth of a hundredth of a normal volt. These.
And this is?
That's AC. That's what you measure your wall outlets. So that's
your wall outlets.
Yeah, you can measure it.
Okay, let's go on to check it out. Oh, we have here.
Ah, also.
Yeah, let's check it out to understand
don't
the working.
Don't do this with cheap meters because they might not have a protection fuse, and you don't want to blow these things up or might hurt yourself. So I'm not responsible for anything. Oh, those have a protection.
Okay, let's go to the wall outlets to see how you test your how this thing works.
So 225.8 volts AC.
That's between 220 and 230.
Yes.
Yeah.
And therefore, if you have an amplifier with a voltage selector, put the voltage selector on 240 volts instead of 220.
Yeah.
It's better for the transformer to do that.
Yeah. What I do with this meter, sometimes you cannot see if a lamp is a bulb is burned out, and then I put it on. I'm gonna show you. Put it on sound. Yes, this is sound. And can you take over the cam? And then I place the bulb, you know, plus and minus. You know, if you have those normal bulbs, you on the underside you place one, and on the side, and then you can see. You don't see if the bulb is still okay. You will hear this. You will hear a sound. If you, for example, a fuse bulb left and right. If you connect these two things on the left and right side from a fuse bulb, you connect them, you don't hear nothing, then the fuse bulb is out. But if it is okay, the bulb is okay, you will hear this. Same counts for fuses. You know, if you have those modern fuses with that sand material inside, you don't see a wire anymore. You just test it like this, you know, and then you hear, if it is okay, you will hear this sound. And that's why where I use this meter for well, most of the time. Now I have another, Simon just learned me how to test your amplifier with this meter, and I'm happy. He explained me a few times over the phone. I never understand, but now I understand. I just have to place it on 200 millivolt.
Yes, on the millivolts.
And then just connect this red to the plus and the minus sides from your amplifier. And then you will have, you can see if this amplifier is good enough to connect on your expensive speakers. Well, this was the video I want to show you. I hope I learned from this today. You know, I didn't know that. Probably you know, if you have more experience with meters. I never use meters, you know, I'm not that technical. But anyway, probably you will have a meter in your cabinet somewhere. Then you know now how to test with this meter your speaker out, if the thing is okay. But don't forget to test it extra with a headphone, you know, all the switches, you know, even the knobs, the treble, the bass, and there can be a fault in the treble and the bass, you never know. And clean it until you don't hear any noise when you connect it to your expensive speakers. Because, you know, when I blew up my Cantons, I had a hard time. Lucky for me, I bought one set for 30 euro tweeters. I bought the other set for 80 euro. That was the more. So for 110 euro, I bought second hand four new tweeters. But those tweeters from my Cantons, if you buy them in the shop, they cost, I think I saw price for 170 euro in one. You buy the new 170 euro new. I bought them second hand. You know, you have to be smart and buy them second hand. See if you buy some smaller speakers, you know, cheaper speakers have the same tweeter. So this is how smart you have to be if you don't want to pay 170 euro for only one tweeter new in the shop. You know, so this is when it goes wrong, you know, there's always a way to find your tweeter. You know, your woofer, if you buy a damaged speaker, you know, but the woofers are still good. You always find a way to find those drivers cheaper than you have to pay in the shop. Well, this was, I hope you learned from this. I learned from this. This was the video how to check your speaker out, you know. If the amplifier, if you don't want to take a risk, and I advise everybody, it will not happen often, but it happened 2 times to me, you know. So that's why I'm happy to learn. I just learned a way to avoid that problem. Thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up and subscribe on my channel. Yeah. Ciao, ciao.